Okay, guys, let's continue talking about some physics. I want to calculate accelerations. But before we do that, just take a look at this and let's see if you've been paying attention, and you should be able to give all of these units for each of these measurements. So just pause the video and then tell me what the unit of each one of these is. What's the unit? So we know distance is in meters, time is in seconds, speed or velocity is in meters per second, acceleration is meters per second squared, and force is a newton, which is a kilogram meter per second squared, right? F is equal to m times a, kilogram is the mass, a is the acceleration, m over s squared, so it's this thing right here is just a newton. We'll come back to that later. So what is the distance between these two graphs? That's what we're looking at. What do you think is different other than the color? Well, the first thing you should be looking at is the axes. So we've got time on the x, that's the same, time in seconds, but look at the y. We've got velocity and we've got position. So this is really distance. This is a distance versus time graph, and this is a velocity versus time graph. So remember, just like before, when we calculated velocities from this graph, we can calculate accelerations from this graph, and that's what I want to show you guys or remind you. We already talked about this last year. The acceleration of an object or anything is the acceleration is defined as the change in a velocity. So if you remember, if you have a distance versus time graph, you know, that looks something like that, you can figure out the velocity at some time or between some time points. Similarly, with a velocity versus time graph, you can figure out the acceleration between two times. Okay, because if the velocity is the change in the distance over the change in the time, then we can also say that the acceleration of the object is the change in the velocity with respect to time. This is what we've already kind of gone over this, but if you need to take some time with acceleration, because for whatever reason it's a hard physics term to wrap our minds around. I remember at your age I had a very hard time understanding acceleration. It's just a change in velocity. If you understand speed and how fast something goes, you can understand acceleration too, because how fast something goes is just velocity, right? It's going very fast, meaning it's covering a large distance delta d over a small amount of time. Acceleration is just how fast your speed or your velocity is changing. Are you slowing down? Are you going from 30 meters per second to 20 to 10? Are you going up? Are you going up in velocity? If you're going up in velocity, you're accelerating, that sort of thing. But yeah, this is what you need to know right here. The acceleration is delta v over delta t. And that is Vf minus Vi, just like we were doing before, Tf minus Ti. We've done it a million times. So what are the units of the acceleration? Okay, so acceleration is just a measurement. So it needs a unit. Well, velocity was meters per second, and the unit for time is seconds, so meters over seconds, as we've seen. Ooh, don't write it like that. Write it like this. As we've seen, this is the unit of acceleration. Okay, meters per second squared. So let's look at some examples. Mr. Sadler walks down the hallway at a constant velocity of 5 meters per second. What is Mr. Sadler's acceleration? So what would my acceleration be in this problem? Well, I'm walking at a constant velocity of 5 meters per second. So what does that mean? That means as time goes on, my velocity is not changing. So I'm just sitting in a car, right, going along at a velocity of 5 meters per second. And if I'm watching the car, if I'm watching the car from right here, right, and I start my watch at time is e t, t is equal to 0 seconds, and then the car keeps going, and then it's here at some other time. Let's say time is equal to, I don't know, 1 second. But the velocity of the car is still 5 meters per second. Then all we gotta do is figure out what its acceleration is. Well, what's the acceleration of something that's constant? Well, let's see. Let's do the calculation. The acceleration is delta V over delta T, which is 5 meters per second minus 5 meters per second, because you have to do VF minus VI. And then what's the change in the time? Well, there's just 1 second minus 0 seconds. So it's 0 meters per second squared. Oops, 0 meters per second over 1 second. 0 divided by anything is just 0 meters per second squared. Okay, so the acceleration is, that's what it is. A is equal to 0. A is equal to the acceleration. So if something's going at a constant velocity, the velocity is not changing, then the acceleration is 0 because the velocity is not changing. Okay, and that's what we said. The acceleration is 0 meters per second because the velocity isn't changing during that time period. Let's see this one. Mr. Sadler sits on a park bench at rest, meaning his velocity is 0 meters per second. So Mr. Sadler's just sitting there, he's chilling. The velocity of this guy is 0 meters per second. What is his acceleration? Well, if he's just sitting there and sometime later it's still 0 meters per second, the velocity hasn't changed. So the acceleration is delta V over delta T. If the velocity hasn't changed, then the change in the velocity is 0, right? It doesn't, there is no change in the velocity here. So the acceleration is 0 divided by whatever delta T could be. It's still 0. Okay, so the velocity doesn't move, or the velocity doesn't change. So if the velocity of an object doesn't change, then the acceleration doesn't change either. It's 0. So let's take a look at this one. Mr. Sadler and Mr. Sneer racing down the hallway. They both start running at 5 meters per second. Both of their velocities stays constant at 5 meters per second. Who finishes the race first? Well, if I have, notice that word constant. So if I have a velocity of 5 meters per second, and Mr. Snee also has the same constant speed, then we will. Oh, I'm sorry, this is a little messed up. Let me fix this for you guys real quick. Mr. Snee has the same velocity, right? You guys are my guinea pigs. So if we both have the same velocity the entire race, it would be like two dots, right, sitting there moving across the floor at the exact same rate. And they'd be sitting there moving, what was it, 5 meters per second? They'd be sitting there moving at 5 meters per second, and whenever, and they would both get to the finish line at the exact same time, right? Assuming they started at the same place. So there'll be a tie here. Okay. Now for this one, this is why the slide was messed up. So let's try it again, except this time Mr. Sadler and Mr. Snee are racing down the hallway. They both start at 5 meters per second, but Mr. Snee accelerates. Mr. Sadler never accelerates, but Mr. Snee does. So who's gonna win the race? So if this is Mr. Snee and this is Mr. Sadler, I keep running the race the same pace, but Mr. Snee accelerates, meaning he starts to gain velocity, right? Acceleration was delta V over delta T. If my velocity increases, I'm accelerating. So that's what it's saying here. Mr. Snee accelerates. So that means his velocity changes. And in this case, his velocity goes up and he finishes the race a little bit faster than Mr. Sadler because his velocity went up. Okay, Mr. Snee had to finish the race first because he accelerated, because he changed his velocity. So you probably played with this simulation. I'll let you guys type that down if you want. We'll just leave that for class. Same with this. So you should definitely be writing down how to do these problems with me, because I'm doing my best to make sure you understand how to calculate an acceleration. Notice I write this down 1,000 times, and you should write it down so many times that it doesn't even bother you anymore, just because it needs to be concrete in your head. So let's look at this problem. A car went from 0 meters per second to 25 meters per second in 5 seconds. What is the acceleration of the car? Okay, so you've got two velocities in the problem, and you've got one time. So notice the final velocity goes right here. That's the final velocity. And so you put in 25 meters per second. The initial, going from the equation, is the blue. So minus V final, 0 meters per second. T final is always the final time, the larger time or the only time. Because notice in this one, they didn't give us a second time, so T initial has to be 0 seconds. If we only get one time, that time is the final time, and then initial would be 0 if there's only one time, okay? So what's 25 minus 0 is 25 meters per second. 5 seconds minus 0 seconds is 5 seconds. 5 meters per second squared. Okay, so read the question again. It says a car went from 0 meters per second to 25 meters per second in 5 seconds. So the velocity went up, and all you did was calculate the rate that the velocity went up. This is really saying the car's speed increased 5 meters per second for every single second that passes. That's all the acceleration is telling you. And that makes sense, right? Because it went from 0 to 25 in 5 seconds. Well, then it had to have increased its speed by 5 meters per second for every second that passed. That's what this is saying. That's what acceleration is. Keep working. If you still don't understand acceleration, keep trying. Bang this into your head, and then eventually it's going to click. So a car went from 15 meters per second to 5 seconds. So let's see. Let's do it again. Acceleration is delta V delta T, which is equal to V final minus V initial over T final minus T initial. V final minus V initial over time final minus time initial, right? Just like we did before. But now the car goes from 15 meters per second to 5 meters per second. So notice it's flipped. The final isn't always the largest number. The final is always the last velocity that they give us. And then look, I put in V initial, which was 15 meters per second. T final, which was what, 5 seconds. And then what's V initial? Well, it only gave us one time. So t initial is automatically 0. So what's 5 minus 15? Minus 10. 5 minus 0 is 5. 5 seconds. So what's minus 10 divided by 5? Minus 2 meters per second squared. So what does that mean? That means that the car is slowing down. This is like you pressing on the brake pedal. It's telling you that the velocity is going down. That's what that means. The velocity is going down 2 meters per second for every single second that passes. That's what it's saying. Let's see how we doing on time. Okay, I'm going to give you one more example and I'll let you go. So a car went from 0 meters per second to 25 meters per second in 15 seconds. What was its acceleration? Okay, so just do it. You should be on a piece of paper just following along with me. So V final was what? It's the last velocity that you get, 25 meters per second. What was the initial? 0 meters per second. What was the change in time? Well, it was 5 seconds minus 0 seconds. 25 meters per second over 5 seconds, which is 5 meters per second squared. Notice I don't skip a step. All the units are in there, okay? And don't skip a single step. If you want to do physics correctly, you cannot skip any steps. 55 meters in 5 seconds. What's the velocity of the car during that time? Ooh, notice I switched it up here. So be ready. I didn't ask for an acceleration this time. I'm asking for velocity. And you can tell, I put it up here in big letters, calculate velocity, but look at the problem. It says a car travels 55 meters in 5 seconds. So you're thinking distance and time. And then it even says, what is the velocity of the car during that time? So now you got to calculate the velocity. Well, it's just 55 meters over 5 seconds. 55 divided by 5 is 11 meters per second. Let's do this one. Well, I'll let you do this one. Pause the video. Do that one on your own. It's easy. It's just a distance over a time problem, right? Same with this. Same with this. But now we're doing acceleration again. So you just got to be able to, you gotta be able to switch back and forth from acceleration and velocity. For example, a rabbit is running across the field that has a velocity of 5 meters per second. The rabbit sees a fox and decides to run faster. Over the next 5 seconds, it reaches 10 meters per second. So the hardest part about physics is getting these variables, VF, VI, TF, and TI, out of the word problem. So what is V final? What is the final velocity of this rabbit? Because the rabbit sees the fox and wants to run away. So it says it reaches a final velocity of 10 meters per second. And then the initial velocity was 5 meters per second. That's the velocity that the rabbit starts with. And it says over the next 5 seconds. Notice there's only one time that they gave us, so 5 seconds must be time final and time initial must be 0 seconds. So 10 minus 5 is 5 meters per second. 5 minus 0 is 5 seconds. 1 meter per second. Ugh, I should not write that way. Guys, always write it this way. Alright. I want you guys to write it this way, just because you're practicing with exponents and I want you to start getting sloppy like this, unless you absolutely understand your exponents. We'll leave it at that though. Okay, so you just gotta be able to calculate accelerations and velocities. Good luck in your exit ticket. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.